Hello, Clinic. No, this is not the chocolate fantasy hotline. No, this is not the fruity booty line either.
How you doing?
How was your spiritual retreat?
Oh, man, it was incredible. A week of fasting, spiritual cleansing. We are centered. We are focused.
We are ready for a double bacon cheeseburger and a side of ham hocks.
Now, you see, Tony, it's that lack of discipline that started the riot at the retreat.
Oh, don't exaggerate, Marion. All I did was make some of my Aunt Gertie's famous wildberry punch.
Which got everyone high and turned our love and sensitivity hour into a why you suck session.
Well, you'll have to tell me about the rest later. I don't want to be late for my UCLA open house today. I am so excited.
That's cool, Tiffany.
Ooh, college girl, I'm so proud of you.
Thank you.
You know, I considered going to UCLA.
Really? What happened?
They considered it, too.
Hey, welcome back. I missed you guys.
What, no jokes about our spiritual retreat?
No, I realized that we all have room to grow. Well, shut up, Tonia. Now, I think we've learned that we all work best when we support each other. So, if you two want to live like homeless people with incense, I respect that.
Well, I'm glad to see you believe in teamwork, Max. Actually, Tonia and I each had a spiritual awakening, and I'm going to dedicate myself to excellence by redesigning the clinic.
That sounds great. Count me in.
And I'm making a major life change, too. Now, you guys know I'm always inventing things like the butt ball, the kink be gone, and the groin master 2000?
Yeah, I can still hear the screams at night on that one.
What do all my inventions have in common?
The phrase, sweet mother of God, make it stop?
No, me. They all come from this little head. Shut up, Max. So from now on, no more gadgets. I'm going to market my motivational theories. I even got a catchphrase. If your life is whack, get it back.
Tonia, why would somebody want to get back a whack life?
Made sense to me when I was out there eating them little mushrooms.
No diggity, no doubt, baby. No diggity, no doubt, huh? No diggity, no doubt, baby. No diggity, no doubt, huh? No doubt,
huh? Hi, Tiffany called this over.
Yo, Marion, the UCLA open house was the bomb. Nothing but females, man.
The campus was very impressive.
Wall to wall women.
The dean's speech was informative, too.
Honeys, honeys, honeys.
Carl, I'm guessing they registered you in pencil, huh? Tiffany's upstairs.
You mind if we get some grub?
Well, as a matter of
thanks,
fact,
man. Come on, girl.
Why don't I just add a drive-through window? At least then I could have kept them outside. Hey, Tiff, call Marinella here. They're in the kitchen. And they better not be touching my carob-covered raisins.
My bad, dog.
I wanted to tell Carl and Marinella my news, but I think I should tell you first. I'm not going to college.
What? What do you mean you're not going to college?
Well, I've thought it over, and I just don't think it's for me.
Oh, so you're going to face the world armed with a high school diploma and makeup.
Hear me out, Mary. Now, I've been thinking about this all day, right? A lot of great Americans did not go to college.
Mm-hmm.
Abraham Lincoln, mm-hmm. Harry Truman, Puff Daddy.
Lincoln was self-educated. Harry Truman was already well off. And for your information, Puff Daddy did go to college.
He did? But his videos are so cool.
Tiffany, this is one of the craziest things I've ever heard you say. And there's a hell of a top 10 list already there.
Fine. Go ahead. Lecture me about education and the future.
Yeah, why would I do that? I mean, not a kid anymore.
That's right. I'm 18. I mean, you know, I can vote and I can vote all night long.
I think you should enroll in college, but if you want to go in this direction, I'm not going to stop you.
Well, that's great. Then all I have to worry about is what I'm going to do with the rest of my life.
You won't have to worry about the rest of your life once your mom finds out.
Hey, hi, hi. What's up?
Miss Tiffany here isn't going to college this fall.
Are you crazy? Girl, we talked about this. There are no fine professional men working at hot dog on a stick.
Tony, my future does not include hot dog on a stick. And for your information, some of the managers are not half bad.
Mary, are you losing your mind? I mean, what kind of parent are you?
The kind with no kids. Look, I'm not a daddy. Besides, she's a young adult now.
Lou's flushing her life away like a bad Mexican dinner.
Look, I know Tiffany. She wants me to make her do what's right so she can blame me if it doesn't work out. I'm gonna let her go on this. She'll come to her senses when she realizes what's out there without an education.
And if she doesn't?
I'll be all over like a fat cop on a free donut.
Tiffany, are you okay?
Yeah, you were so stressed out at open house, I thought you already seen your grades.
Okay, I might as well just come right out and say this. I'm not going to college, and I don't want you guys to go either.
What?
Girl, you tripping like a broke leg midget.
Supposed to do if we don't go to college?
Anything we want, that's the point. Why study the world when we can go out and see it?
You're right. We could see the seven continents. Europe, North America, Africa.
Girl, you need to rethink this college thing.
Right now. You know why you can't remember all seven continents? Because you've only read about them in books. Now, girl, come with me, and we will see all those places that you missed in school that day.
You're right. I'm gonna call my parents right now.
Okay, one down and one to go, brother.
No. See, UCLA has 2.5 women for every man. Mm-hmm. So, unless you plan to hook a brother up with a half a female, I'm going to college.
Okay, I guess you don't care anything about those topless speeches in Europe.
Hey, yo, Renee, phone check, homie.
What did he say?
Well, my dad talked me into going to college.
How did he do that?
Two words, new car.
Oh, that was quick. What did he say?
Two words, ass whooping.
Of exciting, man. You guys are gonna really redecorate the place?
Finally, Max, Tonia, and I are working together peacefully.
Ow!
You got a lot of nerve, Max!
Ow! I'm gonna tape your butt shut and wait for you to explode!
Bye, man. Peace. Right.
What's going on here?
Did you see the new plans he drew for the clinic? The entire workout area is gone. It's now replaced with something called the Max Stanton Wing. And your office, it's a waiting room for his patients. And me, I don't have an office at all.
You can use the couch in the ladies' room.
Now, look, I'm ashamed of you two. We're supposed to be working together. And one thing I learned from sports is there's no I in team. So this is what I want to do. What we need the clinic to be is attractive and hot. We need a place where people can heal, work out, or just hang out.
Oh, yeah. Dark wood, slamming music. I'm feeling it. You know what?
How about a disco ball and a condom machine? Look, this is supposed to be a medical facility.
No, it's a motivational rehab center.
You could call it whatever you want, but this is what it's gonna look like.
Oh, so now you're
smarter than you.
The earthquake's over.
Maybe for you it is. My bad.
Oh, hope the clinic's okay.
Well, we called the landfill. We wanted to clean it up.
Okay, I got ceiling cracks fixed and the door rehung. Tiffany's Spice Girl CD got trashed.
Oh no, did something fall on it?
Yeah, my foot. What's up, guys? I'm glad you can come over. So, the village people having a reunion?
No, I'm just taking some precautions in light of our recent disaster.
Well, anyway, I dogged our claims adjuster and got him to pay off early on our earthquake insurance. Now, under the rules of our partnership agreement, I received these three checks made out to each of us.
Damn! That That's a lot of cheese. Do I get another check if I light that joint on fire?
Now, the good news is maybe this earthquake was a blessing. We could pool all our shares together and rebuild the clinic from the ground up. Now, look, first thing we need...
Sorry, but I think I'm going to take my share and move on.
What? What, you're kidding, right?
Look, I can't handle this. In Boston, the only time the earth moves is when a Kennedy falls off a bar stool.
Max, this can't be all about an earthquake. I mean, I'm happy you're leaving and all,
look,
but I...
Maybe this partnership wasn't in the cards. I mean, we couldn't even agree on how to redesign the clinic. Maybe it's time for me to move back home and give big-time medicine a shot. Look, I'll call you later. Sorry.
Can you believe that? Well, Tonya, I guess it's just you and me.
I don't know, Mary.
Oh, come on, Tonya. Don't tell me you're going to jet on me, too.
Mary, the clinic is a disaster. We're going to have to hire another doctor, and you know how hard it was to find that one in our budget.
No, but we'll figure something out.
Maybe the earthquake was a sign. I want to market myself as a motivational speaker. And this check is talking to me.
Take the money and run. Take the money and run.
Fine. Go on. I can make it by myself.
I'm really sorry, Marion.
Yeah, cool.
I'll always be your friend.
Yeah.
And I will always love you.
So, Al, you think you'd be able to do the renovations for the price I quoted?
Yes. On Barbie's dream house.
I was afraid of that. You know, your contractors are probably making a lot of money right now. Ever think about investing in a clinic?
Good one.
Tiff, when you get around Spain, make sure you go running with the bulls. And in Japan, check out the Kabuki Theater. And when you get to the motherland, give me a phone number of one of them Egyptian honeys.
Now, Carl, what are you going to do with an Egyptian phone number?
Hey, I'm striving to become an international player.
That's a big leap from local fool. Tiffany, we bought you something.
Oh, President, you didn't have to do that, you guys. Yeah. Oh, a backpack.
Thank you. You guys are the best.
What's up, everybody?
Hi. Well, we have to get going. There's a pre-college party tonight.
Yeah. Yeah, we gotta go. Peace out. And don't forget about that Egyptian thing, all right?
Okay.
You okay?
Why wouldn't I be okay? I'm on a roll. I can run the clinic any way I want to. No more Max crying about the sprinkler leaving water spots on his car. No more Tonya telling me about her crazy Uncle Hootie with the eye in his ear. No more, love you. Yeah. Are you okay?
Me? I'm on the adventure of my life.
What's that?
It's a present Carl and Raynell gave me.
That was nice of them.
Yeah, they gave it to me because I am leaving. Because I am their friend. Because I'm a fake. I'm not going to see the world. I don't want to go alone. I don't want to stay here. I don't know what I want to do.
So are you ready to talk about college for real now?
The open house. It was...